So last night in the NHL saw two sweeps in the first round of the playoffs. The New York Islanders sweeping the Pittsburgh Penguins 4-0. And then the big one that everyone was talking about, the Columbus Blue Jackets sweeping the Tampa Bay Lightning 4-0. I'm not going to cover that one in a video though, because I kind of already talked about it yesterday in the video when the series was 3-0, because I'm sure everyone knew that Tampa Bay was not going to come back from a 3-0 deficit. So if you guys missed that video, go check it out after you're done watching this one. But I want to talk about the New York Islanders in this series, because they've been a Cinderella story all year. After losing their franchise player, I think that helped them. It made them all band together, say, okay, we don't need him. Let's show the world that we are a good hockey team. And I definitely think getting Barry Trotz was a huge plus. And going into this series, I had predicted the Pittsburgh Penguins to win it, and like a lot of other people did, because, you know, Pittsburgh, they're always a threat to go deep in the playoffs. And this New York team was kind of a wild card, but they really showed that they are for real, sweeping the Pittsburgh Penguins 4-0. In my opinion, seeing these two powerhouse teams like Pittsburgh and like Tampa Bay being swept in the first round of the playoffs, it just makes the remainder of the playoffs that much more exciting, because I think the Eastern Conference is wide open and any of the remaining teams I could really see making that push and going to the Stanley Cup final. So it definitely should be an exciting remainder of the NHL playoffs, and I think this New York team is definitely built for a deep playoff run in terms of built from the net out. And Jordan Eberle led the way in this series, 4 goals, 2 assists, 6 points. Matthew Barzal, 5 assists. Josh Bailey, 3 goals and 1 assist for 4 points. But in my opinion, the MVP of this series was Robin Leonard. What a pickup this previous offseason for the New York Islanders. He finished the series with a 4-0 record, a 1.47 goals against average, and a .956 save percentage. Those are some very, very impressive stats. And I think this offseason that could go down as one of the bigger pickups. Obviously, John Tavares is the big one, but Barry Trotz and Robin Leonard for this New York Islanders team definitely could be, you know, some of the smaller pickups that made the biggest difference. And then you look at what they held them to. Crosby, 1 point, -4. Jake Gensel, a 40 goal scorer with just 1 goal in the series, no assists, so 1 point and -3. So the New York Islanders defense really did their job in shutting down the Pittsburgh Penguins. They had a phenomenal all around series. And for me, even when they're up to nothing, I was kind of like, okay, this Pittsburgh team, I think they're going to keep it interesting. I think we're going to see a long series here. But New York, they were just relentless. They didn't want this to go any more than 4 games. And for their fans and for this organization, definitely is a very, very welcoming sight. Seeing them sweep a team that has won Stanley Cups in the previous series, that has superstar players like Crosby and like Evgeny Malkin. So this team knows that they can beat teams that have superstar players. They just have to trust their defense, trust their goaltending, and I definitely think the New York Islanders fan base and the organization could be in for a very deep playoff run this year. The one thing, in my opinion, that does suck though is they are going to have to move back to the Barclays Center from Nassau Coliseum for the remainder of the NHL playoffs. I really hate this move from the NHL because the environment and the atmosphere at Nassau Coliseum for those first couple of playoff games was ridiculous. It made this, for me, one of the most fun series to watch, especially when they were playing at Nassau. And now going back to Barclays Center, you're still going to get that amazing fan support, but it definitely is not going to be the same. You're going to be losing something, especially us as viewers seeing that SUV down by the ice. Some fans are going to have obstructed views and stuff like that, and it just won't be as loud. So that really does suck for the New York Islanders. I wish they could have finished the remainder of the playoffs at Nassau Coliseum. Hopefully Lou Lamoriello can, you know, maybe try to figure something out there and maybe get that decision overturned, but it's not looking like that will happen. So they will be playing at the Barclays Center for the remainder of the playoffs, which does suck, but I definitely don't think it really should affect this team's on-ice performance. And I'm definitely kind of pulling for the New York Islanders. They're an underdog team. I like seeing underdogs do well, and for the organization and for their fans, hopefully they can keep this up and continue and make this a really, really deep playoff run. So that is going to wrap up the video. I really hope you guys did enjoy, and make sure to let me know down in the comment section what your thoughts on this series are and what you think is going to happen next with the Pittsburgh Penguins, because they kind of got dominated in the series. Do you guys think they're going to come back next year with the same roster, same coaching staff, and try to make another run at it? It's going to be an interesting offseason for them. And if you're a New York Islanders fan, make sure you let me know what your thoughts are on your team's chances for the remainder of the playoffs. So with that being said, I hope you guys all enjoyed the video. If you did, please make sure to drop a like on it and subscribe to the channel for daily NHL content, and I will see you guys all in the next video.